Back in the summer of 2018, I quit my job, packed my bags, and with some dedicated friends, we got to work building my dream energy independent 100% solar powered camper van. These are the lost tapes in our new series, showcasing all the details of the Rook Del Sol's van build. This is where the journey from Alaska to Argentina began.
This is my serious unloading aluminum face.
Get the end down and then just grab the end and set it down.
Better get to work, eh?
Pull it apart. 25 feet long and 300 pounds.
Got it?
This is our aluminum for the solar panel array.
Why is the best? Right in the yard.
We just came to pick up Joel, and he's running because he saw the panels.
Get cut them! My panels!
Brother!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Thank you, Kira.
Come on.
Yeah!
The panels are here!
Okay, we finally got the panels. It was crazy getting them. We had to go to the shipping place and then go back to customs, and then they said they couldn't figure it out, and so we had to get a broker, and the broker did it in like half an hour. We made it to the shipping place a half hour before they closed, otherwise we would have had to wait till Monday. So we have our panels now.
Here's our panels.
So far so good. They have the diode bridges on the back. 330. So as far as I know, these are the largest flexible panels you can get. Any larger, and they obviously become quite a handful. So they're about 7 feet by about 30 inches. So they're 16 by 6 cells. Cells being roughly about 5 inches. So hopefully now, when we electrically test them, they'll check out. We'll frame them up with our aluminum.
What are those?
Oh, they're just little corner brackets, but so much of the stuff is like cut really perfectly, and it's just really beautiful and shiny. I like shiny things.
Alright, so the dudes are building solar panels here. They have built these elaborate frames, which are very precise. One more, and then we have our first entire panel complete, our first
990 watts, so essentially there's 8,000 watt arrays.
Yeah, so
one, that's nominal, of course.
1 kilowatt hour of solar.
Put one in the middle, maybe?
Per array. So there's going to be 9 of them. Is that right? No, 7 of them.
8.
8 of them. And Ashland's still quite smoky. We've been working in the smoke, still in the front yard.
I got one screw. Two
panels, and one more to come, and then that's the first array done.
So we got our 1,000 watt arrays together. They're actually 990 watts nominal. We had a problem with sagging, so we had to kind of go at it, and we added a little quarter inch strip down the edge, which gave us just what we needed to get the stiffness we wanted, so that we can pull these out and feel confident that they're going to hold their shape. And also, you know, the challenge here is to keep them thin. They're only an inch wide, so to get stiffness out of something that thin is challenging. Originally, I had designed this in carbon fiber, and the carbon fiber guy kind of fell through on me. However, the aluminum's a little cheaper, not much, but a little cheaper, and a little easier to work with basic tools. And so we opted to make it out of aluminum, and it seems to be working out well. So this whole array ends up coming in at about 50 pounds. This would be 120 pounds of normal glass surface aluminum frame panels, and that just would be too heavy, not only as far as adding weight to the vehicle and reducing range as a result, but we would have to be putting that weight up high on the vehicle, and that just is not good for handling. It puts the center of gravity high, and this fiberglass, you know, wouldn't hold it. We'd have to do a lot of reinforcing. So the flexible panels with our own frame design gives us the opportunity to get all of this solar, 7,200 watts up top, for under 400 pounds versus 880 to 1,000 with the glass frame situation. Hey there, we just started cutting our pieces out for our cassette. So our cassette is going to hold our individual arrays, and they're going to roll on track and roller out. So here's the frame for the cassette. As you can see, there's some pretty good sized angled aluminum there, and then some flat pieces. And you'll see then that the first panel occupies the first bay of the cassette, and then the second panel will occupy the second bay of the cassette. This was Kira's idea, actually, to separate the two so that we didn't have such a long distance to span with such a thin panel, because then it's going to sag. So breaking it in the middle gives us a chance to have panels of that size, the shorter ones, smaller ones, much more manageable ones, and then they'll slide out from each side. You'll see. Getting up around 7 and 8 o'clock and getting going, and we're sometimes working till 9 and 10. We try to get a meditation in there to keep our minds square. It's been really incredible, and we've had, of course, life to situate and two kids on the way. And so that's been hard to juggle all those things, and I think that's part of the importance of this project, is that we've done it on top of the challenges of life, and it's not easy for us, and I think that's not easy for anybody, and that's why a lot of this stuff doesn't happen. But we're the people that go for it and take on the workload and the stress load, because we really want to see solar electric vehicles make their way into the mainstream, so that A, we can have a cleaner transportation system, but also so that we can, as a family and as a community, enjoy traveling this way silently and efficiently in the great outdoors.
It might just be a riveting nightmare. Have you ever had those?
A rivetmare?
Yeah.
Well, not yet. So everything would be solved if these were fused. We're good to go. We need to get this thing done. We got 2 weeks left. Yeah, we just got the top trim, so we're gonna go up now and clamp it up and really measure out where our hinges go.
I'm happily putting winches on my vehicle. I'm not frustrated at all.
We bought three X-Ball 3,000 pound winches, and this is what we're going to use to pull the solar array into tracking position.
Am I live? I'm live. Like, how's my hair look?
You've got aluminum shavings.
Do I look beautiful? I look like... So, I am up to my last winch that I'm mounting. I have been tediously feeding wires underneath the car to get it all the way to this 12 volt battery over here. So if you want to have a look in here, you can see. So all of these wires are the winches. We have four winches, so there's going to be four sets of cables running to the 12 volt battery.
Click the switch on here.
There's a cable under here.
Hit out.
And out comes our winch. So that cable will go all the way up to an arm on our array up here. When it connects to the array, the arm, it's gonna pull the array down, and you could imagine a big table pretty much tipping onto its side and able to track the sun so that we get full use of our solar panels. So that's what I've been working on for the last couple of days, trying to finish it up today so that I can move on to other things.
So we're getting our frame set up. Well, right now we are just fastening down our cross pieces, which are going to be pinned to the main frame, the main cassette frame, and we're just getting that buttoned up right now.
All right, so I'm just pulling the pin out from this side. There's a pin on every crossbeam here. There's pins on both sides, but what they also act as is hinges to tilt this thing up. So one side set of the pins will come out and then will tilt to the opposite direction. So I'm gonna pull this last pin out here. Oops, I just dropped a washer, but that's all right. And then once it's out, place it down. And then the whole panel will be pulled to a certain direction with the winches. So this lifts up like this. And then that's how we track the sun. So if you could imagine this covered in solar panels completely, and then a slider coming out there, almost touching the ground down there, and then another set of panels coming up here. That's our footprint for catching the sun's energy. So.
Putting on our tracks.
But yeah, they're still binding a little bit because we have to shape the tracks.
All right, so we're finally getting our arrays together. You can see there's gonna be one fixed panel on the top. Not quite bolted on yet, but it's gonna bolt through here, and there's gonna be one more. And then underneath that, we have two drawers. So these here pull out, and there'll be some arms that come out and hold them about halfway, a little more than halfway. So we have to build our hinges now. So this is the last thing, is to really get a hinge in there so that we can have the panel supported, something to pull down with them on with our winches, and also something to kind of button up and close this array once it's all together and you're driving. So we're finishing up building. We have to build two more panels for this side. Get the hinges figured out. We may have to build them. Either way, that's what we have left to do. If you were to crouch down and look underneath, you'll see the roller bearings, which are going to handle the tracks, which are connected to our sliding arrays. So that gives us the opportunity to do three times of this top surface area. Half of it pulls out on each side for some nice awnings and three times the power.
I'm not getting super great penetration with the welder's not super hot, but it'll be strong.
It's good?
It's hot.
It's real.
We are down to the wire. This is our last day, full day to work, and it's 5:30 and we are just about ready to put this array up on top of the vehicle.
Well, we have an hour and a half till party time.
We have an hour and a half till party
time.
Better
get going.
We gotta get that thing on the roof though, right?
Yes.
Okay. That must be next.
That's the most important part, right?
Yeah, that's the most
important. They're working on it.
Cool.